This is Ursula Maxwell-Lewis, and I'm at Langdon Hall with Executive Chef Jason Bangerter. And Chef Jason, I'd like to hear a bit about your philosophy and just tell us about your work here at Langdon Hall.
Well, I think my work here at Langdon Hall, my work for the last 20 years as a chef, has really become, you know, my life. And when you are into something as an art or something as a trade, as this is, and everything you do and breathe is what you do, you're always learning. You're always trying to reach the next level. You're always trying to develop yourself. And I think part of coming to Langdon Hall was because of the philosophy here. And the philosophy at Langdon Hall is very much about the terroir. It's about the property. It's about the things we grow, it's about the things that are wild, that have grown here for many years in this Carolinian forest, and bringing those things to the experience of the guests at Langdon Hall, in the spa, in the dining, in the cuisine, in just walking around the property and enjoying it as a sense of place. I think accepting the position at Langdon Hall was about throwing myself into something new and something really true to that philosophy. I think every chef is really about the local, is about supporting community, supporting your local farms, and I really wanted to bring that to the next level. And at Langdon Hall, let me tell you, it certainly is, and as a chef, this has got to be the best gig in Canada. And I think with the people that are here, like Mario the Gardener, the owners Bill and Mary, all the staff, everyone has the same level of serious dedication and passion for perfection and that guest experience. And we're always going for the best. And to be able to pull a vegetable out of the garden that's been grown and taken care of by Mario and the gardening team and the culinary team, and you know, 15 minutes, seconds later, have that on a plate, the amount of flavor, the impact, the guest experience is not like any other place you'll get it. You know, some of the ingredients that we get are only available for a 2-week period, and we harvest those things and use them, and that you're going to see things on plates you're not even going to see at other restaurants. And I think that is a big part of the fun part for us and for the guests. But really, the true essence of cooking and the traditional techniques, those things are all here. We reinvent them in a playful way that is really true to the bits and pieces of the property, where we take elements of the forest and bring it into the dining room table, bring it into playful little accents in the dishes. And I think it's taking those classics and really reinventing them in a fun, playful way that makes dining here a real fun experience.
And of course you trained in London, in Switzerland, you've worked in London and Switzerland.
Well, I was born in Toronto. Good old Ontario boy.
Yeah.
Studied at George Brown College here in Toronto, and studied under a great chef, John Higgins, at the King Edward Hotel back in its heyday for 5 years. From there, went on to Europe, educating myself in Paris and London and Berlin and Olten, Switzerland, St. Moritz, the Swiss Italian Alps, and coming back finally to Canada to settle back down in Toronto. And in Toronto for a decade, working for Oliver Bonaccini, Michael Bonaccini, until coming to finally to Langdon Hall.
Yeah, and you told
until coming me home.
Coming home, and what a wonderful place to come home to.
Yes.
Yeah, and you said you were talking about the BC salmon or a fish from BC that you bring in. That was kind of interesting.
We pull a lot of things from the property. Obviously, in the winter months, it's harder to do.
Yeah.
We don't. So we do, and even in the summer months, there's some products that we use that we just possibly can't supply from our own garden. So we use a co-op of farms in the area where we get direct from the farmers. You know, we still want to be able to use great seafood from our East Coast and our West Coast. But very important to me, that's a sustainable product. It's ocean-wise. One fisherman that I use in BC is Steve Johansson, Organic Ocean. And, you know, I really try to surround myself with suppliers that are passionate about what they are doing. So I know the product they're giving me is the best, that they stand behind it. They're proud. They know it's the best.
Mm-hmm.
It is the best.
Mm-hmm.
And to get those products that you just can't get them anywhere else.
No.
They're great. And, you know, to be able to find fish that's that fresh, straight from the fishermen, straight to Langdon Hall in Cambridge here from British Columbia, you know, a day later, to find fish that fresh here in Cambridge from the ocean is incredible.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, again, that's part of the philosophy, is making sure we have really the best ingredients. And we start with the best ingredients and prepare it all the way from when it was caught to we could receive it, to cooking it and preparing it and making sure that none of it's wasted, really respecting the products. I think that flows through right on into the cuisine and how the dish is prepared, and hopefully when the guest enjoys it, you know, some of that carries on through.
Yeah, well, I certainly have here, and I noticed that your dishes too are very fine and delicate, but sometimes dishes, people try to overplay them. Is that the right way to put it?
Yeah.
It's not, I don't see it here. I didn't see it. It didn't taste that way. It didn't seem to be that way.
I think we start with the ingredients.
Yeah.
And as I said, if the ingredients are the best they can be, they're ripe, they haven't traveled a long distance, they're local, they came straight from the farm, they came straight from the garden, they came straight from the fishermen, you're starting off with something that's fantastic.
Right, right.
And very little needs to be done. You don't have to play with that.
No.
You know, you let it speak for itself.
You've got good ingredients.
Yeah. I think at this level, the expectation though sometimes is that it's not the same that you're going to see everywhere else.
No.
And I think I really try to do things that are playful with the classics. So it might be something that is as simple as, you know, a roast with roasted potatoes and roasted carrots, but you know, how we prepare that roast is going to be like you've never had it before.
Mm-hmm.
The carrots are going to taste like carrots you've never had before because they're coming straight from the ground and onto the plate after they've been cleaned and processed. You know, the potatoes, the same thing, are coming out of our garden.
Mm-hmm.
And the way we prepare them is going to be a unique, interesting way that maybe you haven't had before.
Mm-hmm.
So I think the food here is things that people recognize on paper, but when you get it in front of you, it's something, it's got a little twist.
I think that was my experience. I have to admit that's true. I've certainly enjoyed it. So thank you so much. And you also got an award recently?
Yes, a couple this last year. Actually, we've been very fortunate. We just recently received from the University of Guelph and Food Day Canada, Anita Stewart, the Food Innovation Gold Award for Canada. And we received a Rising Chef Trophy from Relais Chateaux International this year. So we're on a roll.
You are.
We're very fortunate.
You are. And when you look around at this property here with all these, I mean, what a lovely place to be. And of course, the garden is right behind where I'm photographing now, isn't it? The vegetable garden.
Yeah. No, it's a very special place.
Super.
Magic.
Thanks for talking with me.
Yeah,
thank you. Thanks, Chef.